For the past 6 months, my brother have had a Power Ocean installed, and during that time we have evaluated it and its performance. Before this system, there was a Fronio solar inverter installed that was connected to a roof-mounted solar array of 40 panels. It's now replaced by the Power Ocean system from EcoFlow and 15.3 kilowatt hours of battery storage. Here the nominal usable capacity is 14.5, so 4.8 out of 5 kilowatt hours per battery module. And in this case there are 3 battery modules. The system is installed outside, so it has been exposed to the Swedish winter and summer climate. It's rated to minus 20 to plus 50 degrees Celsius. Each battery module is equipped with active heating, so the LFP battery cells can operate even in low temperatures. Each battery module is also equipped with its own BMS module, so if one fails, it won't affect the rest. The active heating and the fact that it's cold during winter means that some capacity is lost due to the power needed for the heating. And the cells is also less efficient during cold temperatures. It has survived during the cold weather, with snow, wind, rain, without any weather-related issues. This feature is one that sets the Power Ocean apart from many other competitors on the market, that most often can't be installed outside. There are a few other things that sets the Power Ocean apart as well. One thing is the inverter and battery module's compact size. The battery modules are only 183 millimeters deep. It's perfect to be installed along a wall, inside or out. Some other things is the generous battery warranty with 15 years. Its performance: each module can output 3.3 kilowatt power and 2.5 kilowatt of input power. With the 15 kilowatt hours and a 3-module setup, that will be a total of 9.9 kilowatt of output power and 7.5 kilowatt of input power. The system is also prepared and fully capable of delivering power to the house in a case of a blackout. It can switch to backup mode within 20 milliseconds in case of a power outage. The installation process and permits can differ depending on what market or country the system will be installed. So if you're interested in a system that you want to work as a backup, it can be a good idea to talk to your local installer first. With the inverter connected, you can use the EcoFlow app or the web portal. In the beginning, there was not much valuable information presented here, but a few months and updates later, the app is now working well, presenting information in an easy to understand way. The app is fast and snappy. It feels like the data is almost presented in real time. From experience with other systems like Huawei, Fronius, Victron, Solar Edge, and so on, the EcoFlow product's software and connectivity is in another league, and the Power Ocean is no exception. The Power Ocean can be expanded with up to 45 kilowatt hours of capacity. That capacity will be enough even for large houses that consumes a lot of energy. If we look on the statistics from the past 6 months, the house total consumption is 20,000 kilowatt hours. This is also including 2 mid-size electric cars. The self-sufficiency level with the solar panels and batteries are 32% during this period. And during the summer, it's up to 50 to 60%. In theory, with double the battery capacity, this could go up more, maybe to 70% and sometimes even 100%. There was a few hiccups in the beginning where some software updates was needed. Also, one of the battery modules had to be replaced due to a faulty heating system, but now it works as it should. Other than these early hiccups, the system have performed as expected and proven to be reliable and working both during winter and summertime. So that's a summary of the first 6 months using the EcoFlow Power Ocean system. Thank you for watching.